Right, now I am throwing one of these, a jug with a built-in catcher at the bottom. This was the first one I'd ever tried, and it worked fairly well. It's just a bit smaller than I intended. So this was meant to hold 500 mil, and to about there holds 400. So I threw it with 100 grams more clay for the base than I would if I was just throwing the jug, and that wasn't quite enough. So what I've done is I've got an extra 200 grams of clay over what I would if it didn't have the foot, and that should make it much easier to get the size. Essentially, all I did with that one was just you throw like normal, but the first thing you do is separate out a small amount of clay at the bottom, and then once you're done throwing the walls, you open that out to be the catcher. Going back to what I was saying in probably the first video I narrated, this is where you want to really cone in at the bottom, because you're not going to be able to compress it very well once you've thrown the piece. But cone it well at the start, it should be alright. So, what I reckon is let's have some clay separately. Open up to what I think is the right depth. Fairly good, maybe a little thicker than that. I always set the depth by resting my hands on the bat. So the fact that I can't do it makes it a bit trickier. Wobble to this back, which is going to make it more fun. Say that is bigger than last time. Maybe not quite enough. Come back a little bit later and put the spout in. Okay. use this without ruining it. Even with 12% shrinkage, I figure that's got to be big enough. I'm going to do a second one, which I might make even bigger again, just to be sure.